Alright friends, welcome back to my channel. My name's Angel, and today we're going to be starting a random number generator chooses how many pages I read for the week. I just did a random generator recently, but I don't think it was page number. I think it was for how long I read for. But the point about those ones is that the things, even if I pick pages, if I pick anywhere, it's still up to like 300. That's still in like about 3 hours of reading for me, if not a little bit less. Whereas if I do like hours, and it's like 1 to 5 or even like 1 to 6, and I work doubles any of those days, it normally does not pan out. Because I physically cannot work an 8-hour shift, go to a 5-hour shift, and so do 6 hours of reading. You know, it doesn't work that way. But when I do this one, I find it works a lot better because then I can still do like some, when like I'm commuting back and forth, I can like read a little bit in the morning. Like if I'm going, you know, if I have like 20 minutes before I head into my second shift, I can read a little bit then. And then at night I grind out the rest if I have to. It's kind of fun. I am currently reading Sleep Tight. It's a thriller that I picked up in my last vlog for like getting into the Halloween spirit. And so I think we're gonna keep on reading that one. Also, sorry, just pause. This shirt, if you guys, it's a cute little shirt, but it was animal print day where I work. And so I wore this shirt because it like has some Mickeys with animal prints on it. Not that I wouldn't wear this normally, but I felt I had to explain myself. I don't know why, but that's why I'm wearing this. Anyway, I think we're gonna put minimum, should we put minimum 0, I guess? Oh, no, I should put, make 100. 100 to 350, maybe? That could be a good range. Or 100 to 300. I'm gonna put the range in as 3 to 350, and that 4 is a random generated number that they choose from Google. I'm gonna start screen recording and we're going to load up how many we're reading today. I'm hoping, like, it's already like almost 7 o'clock at night when I haven't read at all today, so I'm hoping I get like even like around like 150 to 200 would be fabulous. That'd be good, but like hopefully not too much more than that. It did 339. Okay, so they wanna play. I also wanna bake tonight and do some stuff, so we'll see how that goes. Sorry, it's only 6:38 actually, so I can probably do that. That's fine, I'm being a little bit dramatic, but like still, reading lots tonight, so let's go. It's 8:05, I've barely read. I've read like 20 pages, but I'm gonna start also watching Dancing with the Stars. So we're gonna see how that goes. And we're making cookies, good times. Okay, it's like 10:19. Show just finished up. I've just been like sitting here for a little bit. And during like commercial breaks and everything, I got to page 173, which when I did the math, it means I have to read 192 pages still. I'm so sorry guys, my fan's going, so not sure how great my audio is going to be here, but I did just finish up Sleep Tight and I think it was pretty good. I think it's probably like a 3.5. One thing with this one is I do find near the ending everything's kind of working a little bit too perfectly. Like our main character keeps having these like flashbacks, like realizations of what actually happened that night, but it's only after she's like spoon fed what happened that night and she goes, oh my god, you're right. So I find that like a little bit too predictable in my opinion. I don't like that pacing of it. I wish like she had come to that realization by herself. And then almost like, I feel like what kept happening is they realized something, called her, and then she was, oh my god, you're right. I wish she had more so worked towards like, she had realized something, called them, and then everything pieced together right then. You know, it would make sense if it was the other way around, not them telling her what happened and her being like, you're right. Does that make sense? Anyways though, so this book, today I read 295 pages to finish this off, so I still have 44 pages left. I was going to pick up that Fear Street book, but I think instead I just want to do something just like after reading this, a little more like lighthearted before bed, not a horror book before bed, because who am I? So I'm going to start reading The Bodyguard by Catherine Center. This book I've heard nothing but good things about. I'm really excited to get into it. So we're going to dive on in. I only have to read 44 pages today, which I always love when it ends on a chapter. It doesn't end on a chapter. So I'm going to actually end up reading to page, why is it a long chapter? Ooh. No good. I'm gonna read up to page 54. I'm gonna read today. Hopefully we'll see. But I'm gonna get into this. And then honestly, with how many pages I read tomorrow, I might finish it if I pick like a bigger number again, because I only have like 250 pages to the end after this. So let's start reading. This is my goal. Let's finish this off strong. Alright friends, it is day 2. I did finish my pages for yesterday. I made page 54, so technically I read 10 over. Obviously, like, too much hasn't happened yet. I only made chapter 6, but I'm really enjoying her writing so far, and I knew I would, because I really, like, raised what Catherine Center is writing. But still, it is incredible, and I just, like, love the way she presents things and, like, shows things to the readers. I love the characters so far, so I think I'm really going to enjoy this. I do work a double today, though, so I'm not sure, like, how much I realistically want to get in pages today. I feel like anything under, like, 200 would be a good range, but I said that yesterday to get 339, so who knows? I can listen to the audiobook and like between all my jobs, but I don't have an ebook of this, so I would only be able to read it physically. So I don't want to get like set too high of a number, you know. Random number generator. I also spelled number wrong at first. That's embarrassing. I'm automatically generated to just like 10. 1 out of 10 is where it's at. So I'm going to change it from minimum to, I think it was 50 yesterday. Minimum 50, max 350. I'm scared based on what happened yesterday. Okay, I'm gonna generate it. I can definitely do that. I got 192. So that is doable. That's good. I can do it today. That's okay. Press generate again. I pressed generate instead of stop and I got 350. That's not gonna count. It was the first one. I pressed generate instead of stop. But so 192 pages is gonna take us to like 240. Like around here probably, and I'll just have like 50 pages, maybe 60 to finish off. So I'll probably leave that for tomorrow. If I'm really, really enjoying the book and I get home early enough, I might just binge it and finish it. But that'll probably be like a finishing off tomorrow, starting a new book. So 192 pages. I got to make myself a coffee and run off to work, but let's have a good Wednesday. Alrighty guys, it is Angel from nearly 10 o'clock at night checking in now. I did do more reading than I thought I was gonna do today, to be honest, like before the end of the night. Through my audiobook today, I listened to 75 pages. I made it from page 54, which is chapter 6, all the way up to chapter 14, page 129. So that's 75 pages, which means I don't have that much left to read, I don't think. 75, 192 minus 75. I have 117 pages left to read, so not bad at all. I can do that probably about like an hour and a little bit. You guys know this is kind of like reversed, where she is his bodyguard, he's famous, and she's like a class A really good bodyguard who has been assigned to him. I think it's a lot of fun. Their banter is really good. I'm telling like the scenery we have going on, like where our setting is and just like how they're interacting, characters, everything. It's been really good vibes. This could potentially be a 5-star. I don't want to jinx it now. Thursday morning. We're gonna put a number really quick because I do have to run to work. I hit my 192 pages last night. I believe again I read almost those 10 pages over. That's where the next like chapter ended again. So I read just over 200 pages last night. I am on page like 254, 55, I think. I'm loving it. I was like not wanting to put it down, but I was also so tired that I was willing to put it down. But I think I have less than 50 pages left, like 45 to 50. So I'll probably honestly finish this as an audiobook driving to and from work today, because I am going right from my first job to the dance studio. And then I'm coming home still pretty early, like I'll be home before 8. So it's not like it'll be too late and I'll have time to finish up the rest of the pages after. But I'm still hoping for like 200-ish again. It is at 350 right now, because remember I accidentally clicked generate again yesterday. Like 200, please, or like lower. I might be mad at that, honestly. 67. I'm almost kind of mad about that, to be honest. So I'll pretty much be able to finish The Bodyguard and be like 10 pages of a new book. Okay. Well, it's kind of boring, but very chill day, I guess. Manifest a little bit too hard, but okay, 67 pages. That's easy. My friends made the appearance. It was Thursday night. I just got finished teaching. I did finish up The Bodyguard, and like it might be a 5-star. It might be a 5-star. I'm not gonna lie to anybody. I had to read 67 pages today, and this was 46 of it. So I have 21 left to read. But so I literally just finished this. I think about swapping over. I went to like my TBR cart. I still have like 6 books left on it, and I was like, nobody's really calling to me, to be honest. However, Thunderhead and Obi Fast and Interesting, and I can use my Audible credit for it. So I think I'm gonna do this book next. Mostly because I know also that I'm not gonna get a lot of reading done, because like I go from one job to the other, and I also close the restaurant, and when I close on Friday I'm totally not home to like
like anywhere between 10:30 on the early side to like 11:30-ish, depending. I'm gonna rely a lot on audiobook to and from, and I'm just gonna hope and see. I checked it, and with the 21 pages I have to read, the closest chapter I have to finish on in this book is page 25. So read the first three chapters and get to there. I was considering like reading a bit more tonight and then trying to like rule it over and count it for tomorrow, because I'm not gonna be able to get a lot of reading done. I'm not sure if that's cheating or not. I don't like do that. But also, so I think what I'll do instead is just whatever reading, if there's any reading I don't get done tomorrow, I'll roll it over to Saturday, which is also still technically cheating. I feel like it's a bit better though. I don't know why, that doesn't make any sense, but it's late, I'm tired. I'll read these 25 pages, and it's good that I don't have a lot to read tonight, because I do have to edit up a video and get it posted. It's up now, but have you guys watched this? It's my fall diaries, like getting in the fall spirit vlog. It's a lot of fun so far. I'm almost done editing it, but so I have to finish that tonight and get it all like set to upload for tomorrow. So I'll read these 25 pages, probably take me like 10-15 minutes, and then I'll get going on that. Alright friends, I'm coming to you very late and with no voice, and trying to be semi-quiet because it is Friday, but it is 12, it's past midnight. I haven't even pulled the number yet for today. It's okay. But I was just listening to my audiobook while I was going to and from both my jobs. That's why I was busy all day. I went from one to the other. And I did read from page 25 to 116. So I read 91 pages. We're gonna pull my number. We're gonna see what it is. Like I said, it is already past midnight, so if it's anything over like 150-175, probably gonna have to roll it over to tomorrow. There's also the chance that it's less than 91 and then we're fine, but I highly doubt that. If I pull like 350, I'm done. I'm gone. So let's waste no time and just do this so that I can keep going. So as you can see, is it gonna focus? It's still on 67 from yesterday. Let's all manifest less than 175, please. Can you guys see that? 342. Obviously, I'm not finishing that tonight. I feel like I can just read another 100 pages minimum and then roll over like 150 to tomorrow, but as if it just pulled 340 at midnight. Get out. I really wanted to still do it, but that's not happening. All right, y'all, let's just actually do the math. 25 plus 342. I'd be trying to get to page 367, which is all the way up here. It's only 24 more chapters. I don't think that's happening, but I have a couple updates about this challenge. So the first one is that I came to you guys past midnight on Friday and then pulled number 347 because it was feeling really rude. But I did not finish that number, but I did still get really close. I think I read like 265. So I think I had like 88 pages left. I don't know if math doesn't make sense, but I'm pretty sure I had 88 pages left to read is what the calculator said. Pulled number 342. So I read 279 minus 25. I read 254 pages minus that 342. Yes, I figured 88 pages was what I was short. So I'm still 88 pages behind. And then yesterday, pretty much the exact same thing happened where I just didn't read at all yesterday. So it's actually now Sunday. I'm gonna be continuing the challenge today, but it's already 9:15 at night. And I still figured those 88 pages. So I'm gonna see, because here's what's truthfully gonna happen right now. I'm gonna pull a low number, like under 150, and then add those 88 pages and finish those tonight. Or if I pull like a 300 number again, I'm probably gonna read those 88 pages with it, to be honest. I would just call it a fail for Friday. But like I said, I got to page 279 of Thunderhead, past halfway now. I am really, really enjoying this. And I read this one pretty fast. So I know I can fly through the ending of this quickly. I have about like 230 pages left, 220 pages left of this alone, and then I have to start a new book. I don't know which one I'd start if I start a new one, because I won't finish that in this challenge regardless. But I do have like a couple of fantasies I'd like to start, but we'll see. So
I have it reset, same numbers as last time. It's just 10 now because it's auto set, but it's minimum 50, max 350. I'm hoping it's a lowish one, to be honest, so I can succeed tonight, but it's the same thing as close as. Okay, 182 is not bad. Plus the 80 is 270, and that's getting a little bit much. You know, that's asking a lot. But that'd be like finishing this book and then just like just starting another one. So maybe I can just finish this and then listen to like an audiobook for like a little bit and finish those pages off. Because I don't know what I want to start with that little time, you know? Like, I feel like I'm only 40 pages. I want to get actually, I'd rather just not start a book, you know? But we will start one. It's fine. I did this to myself. Friends, I finished up Thunderhead. I still have 45 pages left, so I'm gonna dive into Chain of Iron. This would be like one chapter with how long Sandra Claire's chapters are, but let's try. Friends, it is the next morning and I'm so sorry if you guys can hear some background noise. We're actually outside in the balcony for the past like hour watching like a Thanksgiving parade go by, and we thought it was done, but I think it's still going because I'm still hearing some cheering randomly. So I finished up last night, so let's round out the books I finished and the one that I just started. First book I finished was Sleep Tight, and this one I said I thought was just like a little bit too, I was like handed to the character, but kind of, you know, like I love thrillers where it's like if you're gonna have like scenes where you're remembering things from the past like you thought you forgot, or like things you didn't know you remembered, I love it when like the main character uncovers that first and that's like we kind of learn about it and then they tell everybody else. That makes sense. I found like the people kept figuring things out, like the detectives, and they tell her like, oh, we think this happened, and she would like then remember, like, oh my god, yeah, it did. That was like a little bit too like handed for me, you know. I still think it was an interesting premise and I enjoyed it, and I thought it was good for like this season I'm reading it in, but I think it is like a 3.5 star probably. Then I read The Bodyguard by Catherine Center, and dare I say this is a 5-star. I still think it is. Like, I was sitting on it, I'm like, no, I'm still really enjoying it. This is a third act conflict that like wasn't really a conflict, kind of got worked out, and it actually was interesting and relevant to the story, and it wasn't just two characters miscommunicating and being annoying. So I did really enjoy that. I knew I was gonna love it except for nothing but great things about Catherine Center, but now I do wanna pick up more of her backlist. I think Hello Stranger is her other like recent that came out that we really enjoyed. I think I'll be picking that up. I thought this was so cute. I love her writing style and like how she presents certain things to you without like explicitly saying it. Does that make sense? I also think there was a romance book that was short, sweet, like 300 pages, but like got everything done in those 300 pages that need to be done. It didn't have to be like 500 pages and really dragged out. It was to the point, incredible, just got it all in there. Then I read Thunderhead, and this one, I think I like it more than sight. I think this is like probably like a 4.25, 4.5. I really enjoyed where we took the story from the first book. Like, I can't really say too much on this one without spoiling how the first book ended, but pretty much this is like a dystopian like YA trilogy, I think. And in like this world, they've like mastered death where like now people don't die naturally at all. I'm so sorry, guys. And for sure, there's this thing called the Thunderhead that's like in charge of everything, but there's these people called Scythes, and they're the people who pretty much kill people. Like, it's called gleaning, but that's how they control like death, I guess you can say. But like, nobody just dies of natural causes, and if you die when you weren't supposed to be gleaned, then they revive you. It's very interesting. But pretty much, I know like from the first book they said they take into account like certain things that used to happen back in the day. So they'd be like, okay, well, this boy is 18, he drinks a lot, and he drives really fast, has a fast sports car, so he'd probably be more likely to die in an accident at that age, so we're gonna glean him. Like, it's very much, like, thought out and meticulous. First book is more so just, like, the introduction to the world, where we are currently, and, like, how the Scythes work and all that stuff, where this book more looks into, like, the corruption, and, kind of, like, fighting back. I guess it's kind of, like, that typical dystopian, kind of, like, rebel thing that's starting to happen going on. But it just looks at like the corruption within the Scythes and trying to alter and fix that. I really enjoy this one. I kind of want to read the next book already right away, but I think I'm gonna finish off my October TBR, and then if I'm still really wanting to read it, then I'll pick it up. And then I did like just start Chain of Iron. I'd read like 45 pages, So I ended up reading like 57 and just getting to chapter 3. I read about that much. That's nothing in the grand scheme of things because this book is like, how long is this one? 600 pages? Yeah, 630 pages long. So it's nothing in the grand scheme of things. But one thing I will say is the second I picked this up and started reading it, I was like, I need to go read a summary of the last book and like remind myself. Because it hasn't been that long since I read the first book. I just don't know why I picked this up. And like, I was kind of like forgetting who certain characters were. And like, I need a refresh ASAP. So I'm going to quickly read a refresh of the first book before I keep going through this. But I love Cassandra Clare's writing of these characters, of the worlds she's created. And so I'm pretty sure it's going to be a really high rated book. Like, I think the lowest I've rated one for books was in the first couple series. I think I rated like one of them like a 3.5 star. And everything else has been 4 star and above, if not 4.5 star and above, I'm pretty sure. And 2 have gotten 5 stars. But after this book, I only have Chain of Thorns, and then I'm caught up to date with her series, at least. Not like her standalones or like connecting books, but like at least with the series, I'm up to date. All right, friends, so that was this week's challenge. We got 350 pages of one other book done. If you guys have any of the reading challenge video ideas you'd like to see me do, please let me know, because I feel like I've kind of cycled through the ones that like I know and I'm familiar with, and I'm kind of like looping back. So any different ones you guys want to see me do, please let me know, and I would love to give them a try. As always, if you guys like today's video, please just like, comment, and subscribe. I'm also on TikTok, Angel's Book Corner, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye. Thank you.